stuff, man.
Yeah, yeah. All right, what else you got to say? I'm just asking the question, my brother Richard. All right.
Good.
Hey, Brother Rich. Thank you. Thank you. You know, in verse 30 of 1 Corinthians 1, it says, "It is because of him you are in Christ Jesus, who has become for us wisdom from God, that is our righteousness, our holiness, and our redemption. Let him who boasts, boast in this."
Amen.
Do you have anything to boast about? What do you got to boast about? Yeah, man. It's not your job, right? It's not your position in your job. It's not the car that you drive. It's not the people that you know. Not the places you go on vacation. No, we don't go on vacation. Go to the beach. Certainly not. I'm in the right room. Okay, focus. Okay. What do we boast about? What is your life about? I'll tell you what I boast about. I'm going to tell you what you boast about. We know God. We know that we're righteous based upon him. And I'll tell you what else we know, which is really tremendous. We know that everybody else is righteous.
Yeah.
What is more valuable than that? To know that your neighbor, your friend, they're holy and they're righteous. That him who boasts, boasts of this. What do you have to give? Absolutely everything. I'm delighted that God lets us do this. You know, the rich people, the strong people, the poor people, the weak people, they just want to know that they're right with God. You tell them. Can you do that? Can you tell them they're holy and they're righteous? Can you do that? Are you allowed to? Yeah. The answer is yes. Yes. All right. So, I want to look at this verse in James, and it's in Roman numeral number 1. You guys know it too. It's James chapter 3, verses 17 through 18. How about this? It talks about the wisdom of God. It says, "The wisdom that is from above is first of all what?
Pure.
Pure. Number 2?
Peaceful.
Number 3?
Gentle.
Willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruits, without partiality and without hypocrisy. Now, the fruit of righteousness is sown in what?
Peace.
By those who make
peace.
Peace." All right. This is what I always find interesting. The wisdom from God. What did you say, peace?
Peace.
Shalom. That's what we're going with, yeah. But the wisdom of God, and you know, you've heard me say this so many times, but you believe it also. The wisdom of God is first of all pure, not peace. Because so many times we experience things in life and say, well, this thing is producing peace. Peace is not the first fruit of wisdom and the antidote. Sometimes we say it's peace, therefore you do it. Well, maybe the things of God doesn't produce peace initially. Maybe it produces unrest, you know? Maybe something that produces peace is not something we're supposed to be doing, you know? But it gives us peace. Like maybe the Lord wants you to go and preach, and you say you don't got to preach, you have peace. Doesn't mean that's from God. You just got peace because you've got to stand up in front of a bunch of people. Isn't it true, though? You got to go to work. You don't want to go to work. Someone tells you to stay home. Ah, peace. This is the wisdom from above. No way. It's not peaceable first. It's pure first. The wisdom from above first has to be right. It has to be dead on. It's got to be the word of God. And then it will produce peace. It will produce peace. But it's got to be right first. Peace is the second fruit. Wisdom from above. It goes all my peace right out the window. Or in the window. You know. I don't know, I really have peace about this, so. I have peace. Tomorrow you're going to call me and cry. And next week is going to be a whirlwind. But you see, even as the Lord unfolds himself to us, I want us to see three elements of this wisdom that's from above. I want us to see first, it's pure, then it's peaceable, and then in its gentle, but really the aspects of what the peace produces is in 18, it's righteousness. The is righteousness. The peace produces righteousness. And you see, what were the prior 2 weeks that we did with Jehovah? Last week was Jehovah Shalom. And the week before that was Jehovah, I know it, I'll just hang for a second. I don't want to go back with your age. But it was Jehovah Makadesh. So Jehovah Makadesh is the Lord my sanctifier. Jehovah Shalom is the Lord my peace. Jehovah Tsidkenu is? Right. Essentially what you have is you have purity, you have peace, and you have righteousness. You see, there's an order to everything. You're not going to get righteous until you have the first two. You're not going to have righteousness in your life. You will not produce fruit and acts of righteousness without the first two. Not the law, but the first two is this. Number one is purity. You have to know and believe that you are right with God. You have to know that your sins are forgiven forever, once and for all. You have to know. You have to know no matter what you do, you are righteous and you are holy and you are sanctified. You have to know. Purity first. The wisdom from above. Purity first. If you don't know purity, we can't go on. We're not going to have peace. We can't even go to step number two without step number one. And you know that. Because the moment that you think that you're unrighteous or someone else is unrighteous, you don't have peace. Yeah. And that's why number one first, we have to preach this message. We have to preach this message. We have to preach the finished work of the cross. We got to tell people their sins are forgiven once and for all. We don't go on a corner and tell them they're rotten, no good, liars, cheaters, and they're giving Christ. It's the wrong message. Have you ever lied your life? Have you stolen your faith? If someone comes up to me and tells me that, I'm telling them, get out of my face. You go up to people and you tell them this. Let me tell you who you are. Do you know that Jesus died for you? Do you know that you're accepted before God? Do you know that you are right with God right now based upon the work of the cross? Do you know that? Do you know that? Do you know that Jesus died for your sins? Do you know that? We preach the love of God, not the condemnation of man. How are they going to know unless the Lord sends a preacher? How are they going to know unless somebody opens up their mouth and tells them who they are? But I believe that we must believe the word of God. We must believe this purity. We must believe it. We must believe it in ourselves. And listen, you must believe it about everybody who walks this planet. And sometimes in one of our families, I don't know, sometimes they're like the hardest to believe, you know? Don't tell me they're pure. Let me tell you something. I'm going to show you a little impure. No, those are unrighteous acts. But they're pure. Amen. And until you believe they're pure, I think we're going to have no peace and maybe some more unrighteous acts. Okay, then I'll sign up. Because I'm done with not having peace and I don't want to see these unrighteous acts on the wall. I'm going to start believing the word of God. I'm going to start believing in purity and holiness. Not in me only, but in everybody. Amen. Let me ask you a question. Do you believe that? What's up? I have to. Because I'm going to use this in future future times of conversation with you all. Yeah. When you believe this, it produces Jehovah Shalom, peace. You are at peace with God. Only then, it says in verse 18, only then can the fruit of righteousness come. The fruit of righteousness can only come when peace is sown. When there is peace, then you will start to see the fruit of righteousness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because I know God looks for the fruit of the earth, but so do I. Yes. And don't you?
Yes.
Come on now. Don't you look for the fruit of the earth and people around you and yourself? Hallelujah. This is how we get the fruit of the earth. And this is also, I don't want to confuse people when they say, hey, but I see this and but I see that. You are accurate. Yes, there are acts of unrighteousness, yes. But I disagree with how we go about producing it, producing the acts of righteousness. That's the only thing I disagree with.